So the first thing that we're going to do is we're just going to create a little sample pivot table from this data that I have. So we'll go up to Insert Pivot Table. These are the default settings. I haven't changed the table that I'm going to create it from. And I'm going to put it on New Worksheet just so it's easy for you to see. But then I am going to check the box that says Add This Data to the Data Model. So when you check that and you click OK, it's going to bring you to the regular pivot table dialog that you'll notice. Nothing seems different yet at this point. It did take a little bit longer to create the pivot table, but that's about all. So make your table the way that you want it before you insert the data in it. So we're just going to put customer name on the left-hand side. And let's do quantity for the values. Now this is how it is before you inserted your column. You want to put a column right here. But when you right click and do insert, it says, hey, you can't do that. It's a pivot table. You can't mess with pivot tables. But now that you've created this using the data model, you can put your cursor inside the pivot table to select the pivot table, go to analyze, and then go over to OLAP tools, and then convert to formulas. And once you do that, this really isn't a pivot table anymore. Let me make it a little bit bigger for you. But if you look in the formula bar, these are still formulas and they're still looking at your original table. And I'll escape out of that. And so if we look at John and you see 4,940, let's go back to the orders. We'll find one for John. We're going to change the 3 to a 300. Go to your pivot table. It's still 4,940. But if you go to the data ribbon and you click refresh all, the formulas update. So it still acts like a pivot table, but it doesn't look like a pivot table anymore. And when data changes in the data source, this will update. So now that it's not a pivot table anymore, you can come in, right click on the column header and just do insert. And you can put anything you want in here. So we're just gonna say, let's add a region, right? And you can type these in. We'll copy down west. And of course, one of them is from the east. And you can do whatever you want. So let's just call this entire table sales. And let's give it a nicer header. Just make it bold. Maybe put a bottom border on it. And let's make the footer look nice as well. And there you have it. It acts like a live pivot table. It's connected to your data, but you can custom format it however you want. You can even move around these columns because they're still being driven by this Q value formula. So I hope that was helpful. And if you liked that tutorial and you want to see others like it, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.